Where's the safest place to sit on a plane if you're worried about a crash? Well, it's probably not here. I'll explain it all. Coming up. Hey, 7-4 crew, welcome back. If you don't know me, my name's Kelsey. I'm a 747 pilot. My channel, 7-4 Gear, is all about aviation. Today I'm here in downtown Seattle, Washington, and this is the view from my hotel room. In this video, I'm going to tell you about statistically where the safest place to sit is on an aircraft if you're worried about a plane crash. Let's get into it. When I was a kid, I remember getting on a plane and thinking about, I wonder where the safest place to sit is in case this plane crashes. And in my head, I thought it would be first class because the pilots are the ones that are flying the plane and they don't want to die, so it made sense to me to be as close to them as possible.
Logical decision, logically arrived at.
While it's reasonable to think that, statistically, it's not correct. In the event of an accident, which is really unlikely, we are, as pilots, in a very cramped area, and the flight attendant's priority is going to be evacuating the passengers on the aircraft. If you've watched a lot of my videos, you know that I talk about safety being the number one priority, and in my mind, not crashing a plane is involving safety, so rule number one, don't crash your plane. I know some of you watch my channel because you have a fear of aviation, and while statistically it is not likely that you're going to ever be involved in an aviation accident, there's some things that I want to give you to consider when you're choosing your seat. One of the reasons that aviation accidents make the news is because they are so rare. If it happened all the time, it wouldn't be on the news very much. So that's something to consider when you're seeing these huge accidents that happen in aviation. It's because it's such a rarity.
So you're telling me there's a chance.
Every day there are people driving their car and they're texting or putting on their makeup or doing something else, and those people are passing you at a very fast rate. So in reality, it is definitely more dangerous to be driving a car than it is to be in an aircraft. The other thing to consider is that not every airline is the same. There are some airlines that are prohibited from flying into Europe or into the US because they have poor training and poor maintenance standards. So those would be airlines that I would personally choose not to fly on. And that's not to say that their pilots are worse pilots or not great pilots. They could be great pilots, but there are definitely some issues that are going on that airline that are prohibiting them from entering US or European airspace. So I would definitely look to see if that airline is prohibited from flying into other countries or over their airspace, because if they are, that's definitely not an airline you're probably going to want to fly with. Let's talk about some of the statistics. I'm going to use some of the stuff from the FAA and the US Department of Transportation, obviously because that's information that I'm able to get and understand a lot easier. This graph shows you the number of accidents that have happened on aircraft above 19 seats. The reason that 19 seats is an important number to keep in mind is under 19 seats, there are different requirements for the pilots, for the airlines, for the maintenance, and all of those things. So an aircraft with above 19 seats has a higher or more strict standard what's required from the airline for training, for maintenance, and things like that. So as you can see, the aviation accidents are on a decline while overall aviation is growing really rapidly. And these are statistics from the Bureau of Transportation. It breaks down the different types of flying as far as which one is the safest. And obviously, at the top of the list of what is the safest, you have airlines. As most of you know, in the airlines, we're required to always have two pilots up there. In some cases, we have more strict training standards. So it is generally going to be your more experienced pilots that have more experience and more training in flying their aircraft. Next, you have what is known as Part 135. Now, I was a Part 135 pilot. I flew with two different outfits that were Part 135 before I went to the airlines. That doesn't mean that they are not safe airlines to fly with. It's just a different type of training, and in some cases, in Part 135, you only have one pilot. When you only have one pilot, you have a higher chance of having an issue, and that's why the airlines have chosen to always have two pilots up there. In your Part 135, you're seeing smaller aircraft. It could be a four-seater, it could be a small private jet. All of those things are going to fall under the 135 umbrella. And with things like infrequent flying and possibly one pilot and maybe different training standards, you have a higher risk when you're doing that type of flying. And in some cases, a 135 airline might be flying into more high-risk locations, and so again, it increases the risk of what could happen in a 135 environment. And finally, the most dangerous types of flying that can take place is general aviation. General aviation are people who usually fly for fun, that could also be student pilots, things like that. That type of flying is obviously the least structured. Usually you have your least inexperienced pilots, and so that obviously increases the risk of what could go wrong. So statistically, the safest seat to be on is on a commercial aircraft, your typical airlines. But which seat on that aircraft is a whole other subject. In 2011 or 2012, some scientists actually set up a 727 to crash into the desert. And they used crash test dummies to see what the impacts were and where the safest place to sit on an aircraft was. And I want you to know, before I get into this, I never choose my seat on any aircraft based on this statistic. I choose a seat based on what I think is going to be the most comfortable for me. Because at the end of the day, statistically, the likelihood of being in a crash on a plane is very, very slim. Unless, of course, you show up to the plane and I'm your pilot, then you probably want to pay attention to these statistics.
Hashtag burn.
So starting from the front of the plane going backwards, statistically, your flight crew, your people up on the flight deck have your lowest chance of survival.
We fly together, we die together.
What?
Oh, no. That's just something we say.
We're up there, like I said, in a very close space, and the front of the plane is going to impact something because it's moving forward, and so we're most likely to have a fatality in the event of an accident. Then you're going to have your first class, and then your middle of your plane is going to be your second safest place to be in the cabin area, and finally the aft part. The reason the aft of the plane is more likely to be safer is because it's further from the impact zone, most likely. Now, there obviously have been cases where the people in the back of the plane had a fatality for whatever reason. But statistically, you're less likely to be injured if you're in the back side of the plane. Now, once you're in the back side of the plane, sitting in the aisle gives you the most options. In the event that there's a crash, you being in the aisle allows you to get up into the aisle and evacuate the aircraft quicker. Another thing that's really important to consider is in the event that you are in a plane crash, you're going to want to brace. Bracing before the impact will definitely decrease the chances of anything happening to you, which will allow you to evacuate the plane faster and easier and possibly help the other passengers around you. At the end of the day, if you are ever in an aircraft emergency or possibility of having an aircraft accident, the most important thing you can do is listen to your flight attendant and listen to your pilots.
You're not the boss of me.
We spend a lot of training, and the flight attendants spend a lot more training than we do as far as for evacuating people and getting you off the plane safely. They're very familiar with the plane, how to work the doors, and how to get you off the plane quickly. So it's important, if you are ever in a situation where you're going to be in an accident, be quiet and listen to your flight attendants. If you didn't see the full crash analysis that I did on Madagascar 2, I'll put a link to that Hollywood versus reality right here. I look forward to hearing from you. Until then, keep the blue side up.